Welcome back everyone. In this session, we will have some fun with the connections. As mentioned in the beginning itself, generally you will have the basic ideas for most of the connection that you are going to give between the different components. Many times, design engineer will tell you that he wants a spot weld, seam weld or V-weld at a particular location. Or he will exclusively mention that he wanted a bolted connection or adhesive type of connection for those particular locations. For our frame assembly project, I have made a dummy connection strategy. But when you work for any organization, in there, your senior engineers will give you the detailed guidelines on how to create the connection between the different components and which connection you have to create between the different components. So based on our dummy connection strategy, you can observe at the right as well as at the left, we have to create a 3-spot weld. Not only that, for this entire flange length, we have to create the adhesives. Now since for rest of the connection, I have not mentioned any strategy. So for rest of the connection, we are going to assume any appropriate type of connections. So without further delay, let's jump right into it. So as per the connection strategy, at this location, here and here, I have to create a 3-spot weld. So let us zoom into at this location. Let us rotate a model little bit and observe properly. As you can see over here, I have 3 components. So let us see which are these 3 components. So you can go for selector window. First click over here. So this is nothing but our left rail outer. Let us click over here. So this is our front truss upper. And let me click over here again. So this is our front truss lower. So I have to create these 3 components using the spot weld. Before going for creating a spot weld, let us create a component first. Let us give it a name as a wheels. And then go for 1D. And then go for connector. And here we will have the spot weld. But since I want to create a spot weld between these 3 components, it is much better practice to create a spot at this middle component. Now to select a node at this middle component, I will have to first hide this component. But there is a better alternative also. So you can press X on your keyboard. Then make sure that the wireframe selector is switched on and just select the component. As you can see, the element representation has been turned into the wireframe. But since the surfaces are on, that's why I am not able to select the behind component. So you can simply press D on your keyboard. Let me first set return. Press D on your keyboard. Here set it to geometry and say none. Now you can see, I am able to see the component which is behind this component. Again go for return, go for node and zoom in at the particular location. So as per the connection strategy, here we will have to create a 3-spot weld. Now since here I have the 4 layer of element, I can simply go for middle selection, then select one over here and let us select one at this location. Again. Here we will have the connect what. So here I will have to select the 3 component. Let me select this one and finally this one. Under the num layer, here since we are connecting 3 component, here we have to select total 3. Tolerance is nothing but the surge distance between the 2 components so that they can be connected with the spot weld. So by default it is 10 only and we are going to keep that as it is. Now for the type is very important. Because different organizations follow different ways to create a spot weld. But since most of the organizations follow this ACM equivalence T1 plus T2 divided by 2, we are going to select the same. So let me select this one. Under the diameter, since we are creating the 3 component, and it is a general practice that whenever you have the 3 component, we keep the diameter as 6. So let me select 6 and simply go for create. Immediately after pressing the create button, you will have to go for the status bar. You can see the status bar is saying 3 spot connectors created and 3 realized. So we have successfully created the 3 spot weld. Now let me set it to return. Again, let me change this element representation and again go for the isometric view. So far we have created a spot weld at this location. Again, let us zoom in at this location and create a spot weld at this also. Now as you can see over here, I have 3 layer of cord element. So here it will be the better practice to create a node in between this cord element. Now to do that, again let me go for return, go for 1D, connector, spot, and for the selection of node, you will have to do one thing. press and hold your cursor over here, and once the white window appear or white outline for that element occur, release your left mouse button and then select the node so that the node can be placed at exactly center of the chord element. Similar way, I can select the node over here, and here also I can select the node. Now the select the two component which you want to connect, so this one and this one. Since I want to connect the two component, here number of layer let us set it to 2, tolerance I will keep as it is, and the type I will keep as it is. But since we are connecting the two component, as per the standard I will set the diameter to 5, and let's go for create now. Again, if you read the status bar, it is saying 3 spot connector created and 3 of them realized. Now again for the next strategy, as you can observe over here, here also I have to create a 3 spot weld. But if you carefully observe, you will have to think. If you observe at this top location, here I have 3 component. So again let me set it to return. Select this selector filter. So this is my rear truss outer. This middle one is nothing but rear truss inner, and this one is nothing but left rail inner. So at this location, if I create a spot weld, I can create a spot weld between these three component. So let me again press X button to make sure that this connection is happening throughout or not. So let me convert this model into wireframe, and this one also in the wireframe. So as you can see, at this top location and at this bottom location, I can probably create a spot weld between the three components. But for the middle location, I will have to create a spot weld between the two component only. Let me again set all to the element representation. Set all. Let me rotate the model and again go for wireframe and select this one. So the thing that I was telling you is that at this location, we can create a spot weld between these three component. But for here, we will have to create a spot weld between only two component. So one is red component and another one is this component. And again at the bottom, we can create a spot weld between the three component. So here we have to make the decision. Again let me set all to the element representation and let us say return. But at the same time, if you observe over here, it might seems like there is going to be bolted connection over here. So in practice, many time it will happen. Once you have the bolted connection, we never use a weld. So here we are going to go with this strategy. Since we are going to create a bolted connection over here, we are not going to connect this outer component by using the weld connection. So for this particular connection, we are going to create a spot weld between this component and this component only. So again, go for connector, go for spot, and for the node, do the same thing. Press and hold left mouse button. White outline will appear for the element, then release your left mouse button and then go for selection. As simple as that. Select the two components and simply go for create. Now I hope you are enjoying so far. Now let us go for return. So as per the connection strategy, we have completed the weld connection. But now we have to create the adhesives. So if you look for the connection strategy, let me again open the PDF. So if you observe the connection strategy, under the connection strategy, it has been mentioned that the adhesive we need to create throughout the flange. So again, let us open the hypermesh. Here, if I zoom into the flange location, here you can observe between this component and this component. That is, let me go for selection filter, select this one and this one. So between the left rail inner and the left rail outer, we need to create the adhesive. So let us press escape button, go for 1D, and for the adhesive we need to go for connector and we need to go for area. Now here we cannot select the node, here we have to select the element. So for the element selection, we need to select these two layer of element. So we can directly go and select one element. Here I can go for element and select by face. But as you can see, if I select the element by face, then this extra layer of element is also getting selected, which I don't want to select. You can go ahead and you can unselect them also. But rather than doing this, let me show you one another way. So here let me again unselect all. Press O on your keyboard so that the option panel will open. Under the option panel, let us go for mesh And here you will have something called as an feature angle. Here let us reduce the feature angle to the 2 degree only and let us go for return. So basically we are telling the hypermesh that we want to select the element where the feature angle is not exceeded by the 2 degree. So now let us select one element and again go for element and go for biface. Make sure that entire two layers of element are getting selected. Component, let me select this one and this one. Important thing is this type. We have to make sure that the type has been set it to adhesive, and here the shell gap has been mentioned. Again, let us go ahead and say create. As you can see, the adhesive have been created. So again, read the status bar carefully. One area connector created and one has been realized. In the similar way, you can create the adhesive at the bottom also. Select just one, go for element, go for biface. For the component, select these two and go for create. In the similar way, we can create the adhesive between these two components also. So select this one, go for biface, this component and say create. So within the fraction of second, we can create the adhesive. So as far as the connection strategy has been mentioned, whatever connections that has been mentioned in the PDF, I have already done those connections. But if you carefully observe the geometry, there are still some components which are not connected at all. Now let us see how we can check the components which are not connected. So let me go for return and press F on your keyboard. So in order to show which components are not at all connected, simply go for F5, select one element and here go for element, say by attach and simply mask it. So these are the elements or components which are not connected to any component. So first let us start with this reinforcement plate. Again go for unmask all, go for return. So here I am pretty sure we will have to create a spot weld over here. So again go for 1D, connector, go for spot. For the node, let me select one over here, second over here and third over here. Go for component, this one, here everything seems right and again go for create. So you can see the three connectors have been realized. In similar way, select these three over here, press tab, select these two component and again go for create. Now I am sure that these two components are connected. But what about these two? They are still not connected. So one thing that we can do, let us observe over here also. Okay, here also they are not connected. Let me go for return. It is always better practice to first observe that whether the connection is throughout or not. So again press X on your keyboard and just convert this element into wireframe. So as you can see, here I have a gap. That means I have to create a three separate weld at this location and three separate weld at this location. So let me again go for return, convert everything into the element, go for 1D, connector and again spot. So similarly select this one and let me select this one. So let us create only two spot. Go for component, this one, press middle button. So in the similar way, this one, tap, select this component, press middle button. So in the similar way, you can create a weld at this location also. For this location, rather than creating a new weld, as we have already created a weld on other side, we can just reflect this weld element over here. This is just another tactic where rather than creating a new weld, you can just reflect the pre-existing weld itself. This is mostly useful in case you have to do the large number of welds. For example, let's say you want to do the 100 spot welds. So it is not possible to manually select each and every node and again create a 100 spot weld. If weld can be reflected, then it is always better practice to reflect them. Now to reflect the weld, first we need a center point. So again, let us go for F4, select this node and make sure you are selecting exactly opposite node. Now go for node between and here I have the center node. Let me go for return now. As you can see, here I want to reflect these four welds. So again, let us go for tools, then go for reflect. Here I will have connector option on. So by default, it might be something like element. So from the element, you have to switch back to the connector. Then go over here and select this four connector. Now once the connector have been selected, select the axis or the plane about which you want to reflect. So as you can see, I want to reflect these four weld elements from over here to this location. So basically, the plane about which I want to reflect is nothing but YZ plane. Now to select the YZ plane, we can simply select X axis. So let me select X axis, and for the base point, let me select this one. We have selected the connector. Here we have to duplicate the connector so that the original connector will remain in their original position and the duplicate connector will get reflected. So again, let us go for connector, and here let us say duplicate. Now as you can see, here there are multiple options, for example original connector group or the model. So let me set it to model and let us go for reflect. Now carefully observe, in the status bar it is saying the connectors have not been selected, but we know for sure that we have selected the connector. So don't worry, this is just a bug in the HyperMesh. So now one thing that I can do is go for return. Here, now keep in mind, at this location I have two connectors. One is realized connector and other one is unrealized connector. So the realized connector will be shown in the green color and the unrealized connector it is currently showing in the yellow color. Now to select only unrealized connector, let us go for view. And from the view, let us switch on the connector panel. Once the connector browser gets activated, you will see the distinction between the realized connector and unrealized connector. So here, let me go for ACM equivalence. And if I scroll it downward, you can see these are the four connectors which are now currently unrealized one. So here, one thing that I can do to make sure that only this unrealized connector is getting selected is that I can just hide the realized connector. So let me select all the realized connector. And right click over here and just say hide. Now as you can see, all the realized connector have been hidden. Again, let us go for tools, go for reflect. Simply select this connector. Let us zoom in. Select these four connector. And for the base point, let me select this one. And let us go for reflect. Let me go for return now. Again, switch on all the elements and let me go for return again. Now if I rotate my model, you can see the connectors are present now. Only thing that we have to do is to realize them. As we have seen in the previous sessions also, in order to realize the connector, simply go for 1D, click on connector, go for spot, and here you will have this option called as unrealize, because we have already created a weld, there is no need to create them again. So let me go for realize, select this one and select this one and simply click on realize. But as you can see in the status bar, here it is saying two connectors realized but two of them failed. So basically connectors are not getting realized. So again, go for the connector browser and see the reason why these connectors are not getting realized. So again, expand it. Let me just expand this also. Let me move it, and here as you can see in the state itself it is saying failed link entity 1 component ID 2 does not have the projection. Keep this error in mind because many time we are going to face this error. So basically what is happening, whenever we talk about the connector will have some information. For example, the connector will contain the information such as the two components which are supposed to be connected, the diameter of the spot weld and their location in the three-dimensional space. As you can see, for this connector, it currently has a information where the two components are going to be connected. So if I click over here, so we have reflected this connector from this location. So this particular connector is basically telling me to connect this component, that is left rail inner, and this is front truss upper. But if I move on to this location, here as you can see, at this point, this is a different component which is nothing but right rail inner. Now since this particular component, that is front truss upper, and this red component does not have the projection at this particular point, that's why it is showing me the error. So first thing that I have to do after the reflect is to change the entity within the component. Now to do that, we can simply go for add link, select this connector, then connect what? I want to connect this component and this again, total 2. Here reconnect rule I will say use ID, and here it is very important to switch on this add link from the scratch, so that this connector will now contain the new information where we are basically telling him to connect this component and this one. So let me select this one. For the search tolerance, as usual we are going to go for 10 and say add links again. Go for return and again try to realize the connector, select this one and say realize. Now if you observe in the status bar, it is showing the two connectors have been realized. So the same procedure we have to do at the bottom also. Select these two connector, press tab button, then these two, add link from scratch, search tolerance 10 and go for add links. Again the only thing that has remained is to realize them. So again go for spot, realize, select these two and say realize. Again in the status bar you can see the two connectors have been realized. So let us zoom in and see whether the RB3 hexa RB3 elements are getting created or not. So as you can see at this location it is getting created. So basically in this way you can reflect the weld also. Now again let us focus which components are not being connected. So let me zoom in at this location. Here also you can see these are not been connected. So again we can just reflect this weld itself. So here again let us go for connectors. Let me go for connector. Here let me again go for selection and let me select all the connectors, and here let me go for show. Here we have two connectors which are not being realized. So let me delete this one because I think they have been duplicated at the same location. So first it is always better practice to know their position and then only delete them. So as you can see at these two location this connector have not been realized, but I can see the weld representation. That's why I can simply just delete them. So let me select it. Here we can go for connectors only. Let us go for delete. Now you can see the green connectors are now present. Now again let us just reflect this weld. So let me go for return. Let us just convert or just hide these elements. Let us hide the surfaces also. Now let us show the connector group. So as you can see here I have 3 spot weld. So again let us go for tools, go for reflect, see the connector and then select this connector. So make sure these connectors have been selected, and for the base point I am going to select the previously selected only, and again don't forget to duplicate this connector. So let us go for duplicate, let us go for model itself and say reflect. Again this is just a debug in the hypermesh. It is showing the connectors have not been selected. So again do the same procedure, just isolate this connector. You can go for isolate and again go for tools, go for reflect, then select this connector. For the base point let me select this one and say reflect. Go for return. Now here again we have to add the links from the scratch. So again let us go for 1D. Now once the link has been added we can simply go for spot, realize and select these three connectors, and again here tolerance let me set it to 10 only, and for the diameter let me set it to 6 and simply go for realize. So as you can see these connectors have also been realized. Now again let us see which components have not been connected. So let us first go to the isometric view. Let me first unmask all elements. Again let me show all elements and let me hide all the geometric element. Let us now for return. As we have seen few seconds ago, in order to identify which elements have not been connected to any other component, we can press F5, select one element, and here we can go for by attach. Now as you can see, every single elements have been getting selected. If I set it to mask, only this component is present. That means this particular component is not connected to any other component. So let me go for return. let me go for elements and let me set it to all. Let us say none and again then say all. Go for return now. So as we have discussed, here we want to create a bolted connection. So let us first create the rigid element for the bolted connection. So let us go for model. Here let us go for create, and I will create a component calling it as a rigid. Then I can simply go for 1D, then go for rigid. Here I will go for multiple nodes, and for the node let me go for node bypath, or here first set it to calculated node, then go for bypath, select first node, and in the similar way select the outer ring also. Make sure you are selecting all the nodes within the first ring of the element. So again let us set it to create. And in the similar way, we will have to create a rigid element over here also. So again, go for node by path, select this one, and simply go for create. Now once the rigid have been created, it's time to create a beam section. So before creating the beam section, let us first measure the diameter that we are going to create. So let us go for one node, first node and third node. So as you can see, currently the radius is 25 mm. So we are going to assume that we are going to place the bolt having the diameter as a 50 mm. So let me set it to return now. So here again, in order to create the beam section, we can simply go for 1D, click on hyperbeam, here go for standard section, from the standard section library set it to hyperbeam, and standard section type let us go for solid rectangle and go for create. Once you click on the create, another window will open. So for the radius let me set it to 25. Make sure you are cross checking this radius double time, because most of the time it will not get placed. And here let me just rename this one. Let me set it to M50, and for this auto here you can change the name also. For example, for a particular client's project, we will like to give the name of that client itself. So here I will give the name of the project itself. So for the auto, let me change and let us set it to frame assembly. So my objective over here is to make sure that everything is in line with the standard that company follow. So let me go for file and let us say exit. Now once we set exit, as you can see, another component collector have been created calling it as a beam section collector. If I expand it, I will get, okay, I am using the bolted for frame assembly project. Then which bolt I am using? M50 is the bolt that I am using. So still we have not created a component. So just click over here, press Ctrl D and simply go for M50. Now again go for return. As you can see, the current component is M50, but let me change the color of this component because we have already created a rigid with the same color. Again go for 1D, go for bar element. So for the orientation, I would like to select the direction node. So here for the orientation, click on this drop down and select the node. So for node A, let me select this one. For node B, let me select this one. And prior to selecting the direction node, make sure that the element type is CBeam. This is very, very important. Again, let me click over here. And as you can see, the CBeam have been created. But till date, we have not created or assigned any property or assign our cross section to this CBeam. Now to do that, we will have to create a property first. So let me just scroll it upward, right click over here, go for create and again go for property. So remember, for 1D we are assigning the property. That means our card image is going to be P bar, P beam or P beam L. So let me go for M50 property. So let us say M50, and here I will just type the letter as a P. So basically indicating it is a property. Again for the card image, as I told you, since this is 1D, here we are going to go for P bar or P beam. But since PBM element will have all the rotation and the translation degrees of freedom, generally we like to select the PBM only. So let me select PBM. For the material, let us go with the steel itself. Let us set it to OK. And for the beam section, we have already created beam section. So just recall that section and set it to OK. Now everything is in order. Only thing that has remained is to assign the cross section to this M50 component. Right click over here, go for assign, and here let us go for M50 property. Go for apply and go for OK. But in order to make sure that it has been assigned, we can go for 1D representation, and as you can see, we are able to see this cross section. Again, click F button on your keyboard, and again we have to take the check whether every single thing is attached or not. So let us go for F5, select one element, go over here and again go for biattach. Again go for mask. Now since none of the component is highlighting, that means every single components are connected. Let us again press D and let us go for all element selection. So as per as our connection strategy is concerned, and as per our experience, we have created all the required connection, but still the connection have not been finalized. See, if I look for the component, you will see these weird components that have already been created. For example, one such component is solid spot ACM equivalence. So right click it and say isolate only. So if I zoom in at this component, then you will find these are the spot wheels that I have created, but these are the hexa element. So again, let me just remove this node itself. Let us go for clear all. Since we are working within the OptiStruct solver, because of which the OptiStruct or the HyperMesh has already created this component. But other than OptiStruct, let us say you are working with the Abacus solver, then this component will not get created automatically. You have to create them by yourself. So first, let me show you how we can do that. So basically, this is just a segregation task. That's it. Nothing else. So let me go for component. And here I will go for spot hexa. So basically here I am trying to tell you that these are the hexa element which are belonging to the spot wheel. Again, let us go for shift F11, that is the organize panel. Let me go for all the displayed element and let us assign them to the spot hexa component. Let us go for move. Let us go for return now. Again, let us click on this RB3 spot ACM equivalence and say isolate only. So again you can see these are just RB3 element. So all these RB3 element we can throw in the one panel. So let me again go for component. Of course we can just modify this component itself. There is no need to create separate one. So just type it RBE3. Now the next and very important component that has been created is this one, solid area hexa. So let me go for isolate only. You can see these are the hexa element which are representing the adhesives. Generally, adhesives have different property. So we have to make sure that we are putting this adhesive hexa element in a separate component. So let me just duplicate this spot hexa and here let me type adhesives. Because for the adhesives, we are going to create a different material. Again, go for shift F11, go for displayed element and just say move. And for the RB3 of adhesive, we can just throw them in the RB3 itself. Let us say isolate only. For the current component, let me set it to RB3. And go for shift F11. Go for displayed and just move them. Now let us go for return. Again, let us show all the elements. And first thing that we will do is to delete the empty component. So press F2 on your keyboard. Here, go for component. And here go for preview empty. So as you can see in the status bar, three components are empty. That basically trying to tell us that within those components there is nothing. So we can simply go for delete entity. Again go for return. As I was talking previously, for the adhesives we have different material property. So first let us create the material property for the adhesive. Let us go for material. Here I will go for adhesive. Then for the adhesive, Young's modulus will be within the range of 600 MPa to 1500 MPa. So let me set it to 1000 MPa. Then Poisson's ratio will be around 0.4. And for the density, it will be around 1200 kg per meter cube. So here, let me set it to density in terms of ton. So it will be around 1.2 e raised to minus 9. Now once the material have been created, again we will have to update the property also. So if I scroll it downward, here you will get the property where it is mentioned that it is for the adhesive. So again, let us just rename it. Now with this property, we are going to represent the solid element. That's why the card image has been set it to P solid. But for the material, since we have created a separate material calling it as an adhesive, let me select that material and set it to OK now. Again, make sure that you are applying this property to the adhesive hexa. So as you can see here, no property has been mentioned. So click on adhesive hexa, click on the property, come to the bottom, and here simply click on adhesive hexa and go for OK. So as you can see, for the adhesive hexa, property as well as material have been mentioned. Now again, let us go for spot hexa. So click over here, again no property has been mentioned. So click on the property. For the spot hexa, generally the material will be of the parent material itself. That's why we are going to go with the by default property only. So let me set it to OK. But here, let me change the name of the property. So here, click over here, and here let us say spot hexa. Make sure that everything is in order. Click on the material for the solid spot, and here make sure that you are selecting the card image. So click on the card image, set it to matte 1, and give the by default property. Again, let us just rename this material also. Now everything seems to be in order. So again, let us delete unnecessary component, material and property. So let us click with the preview empty. So all the components have something within them. That's why it is showing zero entities are empty. So for the properties also, we are seeing zero entities are not being used. So let us switch to the material now. Go for preview and use. And here you can see one entity is not in use. And most probably this is going to be this one, solid area hexa adhesive shell gap. So if I delete that one, so unnecessary material will get removed automatically. So in this way, basically we have completed our connections for this frame assembly project, but still these connections are not been finalized. In the next session, we are going to do the model analysis on the same project, and within that model analysis, if first 6 modes comes out to be closer to 0, then we will say our connections are pretty good. Not only that, for each mode we are going to observe the shape also. So keep watching the next video in order to complete this project.